Hello children, today we are going to discuss about the topic seed dispersal from class 7. Why should seeds be dispersed? Children, you can see a mango tree full of fruits on the screen. What if all fruits or seeds of that tree fall at same place? Then there would be competition for space, water and minerals for the newly growing plants. Because of the overcrowding, there won't be sufficient sunlight also. So the new plants cannot grow well to become trees. In order to avoid this kind of competition, seed dispersal is necessary. Seed dispersal is the process of scattering or spreading of seeds away from the parent plant. Children, we find different kinds of plants growing in our surroundings. How did those plants grow there? Maybe someone planted them there. But what about trees growing in forest? We sometimes see trees growing on cracked walls of old buildings. How did they reach there? Children, do you also get these kind of doubts? Let us try to get those doubts clarified in this video. Children, you know that fruits have seeds in them. When these seeds come in contact with soil, they germinate and grow into new plants. Some fruits have one seed, while some may have many seeds. Children, as you can see on your screen, some of the seeds of different plants are same, while some have different characteristics. Some seeds may be big in size, or some may be small. Some of them may be hairy or have thorns. Let us now discuss about how these different kinds of seeds having different characteristics get dispersed. Now, as we know why seeds should be dispersed, the next question will be, how are seeds dispersed? Plants or seeds cannot move from place to place on their own. So, some agents will help the seeds to get dispersed from one place to other. Those agents which help in seed dispersal are wind, water, animals, birds, and also us human beings. Let us now discuss about each of them in detail. Children, you can see the images of milkweed and dandelion on your screen. Observe them carefully, children. They have hairy structures attached to the seeds. These hairy structures will help them to be carried away by wind to different places. They germinate wherever they get in touch with soil. So generally, the seeds which get dispersed through wind are light in weight and are attached to hairy structures. Children, now let us observe how the seeds get dispersed by wind in dandelion and milkweed plants. Now we will discuss about seed dispersal by water. Lotus seeds get dispersed by water. Lotus grows in water. Its seeds are heavy, so these seeds fall to the bottom of the water and carried by flow of water and get germinated wherever there are favorable conditions. Seeds of almost all water plants gets dispersed by water. Seed dispersal by water occurs in coconut trees also. Coconut trees generally grow along the banks of river or near the seashores. So, when the coconuts fall in water, due to the fibrous nature of the fruit, it gets floated along the waves of the water. Whenever it touches the ground or soil after traveling long distance, there the seed gets germinated into new plant. Children, now let us discuss about seed dispersal by animals. Children, observe the screen carefully. You will notice that these seeds are having thorns and some of them are having hooks. These seeds are having these special structures, that is thorns and hooks, which help for seed dispersal. Thorns or hooks get stuck to bodies of animals and get carried to distant places. You can see in the picture there are many seeds on the body of the goat. These seeds got stuck in the hair. These seeds move to distant places along with goat and they fall down at some place and grow into new plants. In this way, goats, buffaloes, dogs, and different other animals help in seed dispersal. Children, squirrels collect lots of nuts and they hide them in different places for future use. They sometimes forget where they have hidden the nuts. These nuts, which the squirrels have forgotten, will grow into trees. In this way, squirrels also help in seed dispersal. Seed dispersal by birds. Birds carry fruits or seeds with their beak. While they are flying, seeds might fall down and grow into new plants. In this way, birds help in seed dispersal by carrying seeds to distant places away from the parent plant. Birds like crow, bulbul, myna, they will eat fruits like neem and they digest the outer fleshy part of the fruit and leave the seeds in their bird droppings. Those seeds will develop into a new plant. In that way, these birds help in seed dispersal. We humans also help in seed dispersal. We collect different seeds from many places for our garden or field. Also, due to import and export of seeds between different countries, seeds got dispersed all over the world. In this way, human beings helped in seed dispersal. Seed dispersal by explosion or bursting. Some fruits burst to throw seeds out with some speed so that they can fall on ground at a little distance away from the parent plant and can grow into new plants. This kind of dispersal is observed in peas, lady's finger, mustard, balsam. Some fruits also split open to throw the seeds away from them so that they can grow into new plants. Children, in this way, seeds get dispersed with the help of different agents like wind, water, birds, animals, and even humans to go away to a distant place from the parent plant to avoid competition for food, water, sunlight, and to get enough space for its growth. Thank you, children. Hope you understood the concept well.